Yeah, this is Peter from the Episcopal Diocese of Malek. Willing to share with you on today on the topic of the lay mediation. And our topic of today is selected, sharing of today is selected out from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13. And I'm happy to read it to you before we merge into our discussion. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13. It's only that verse. 1 Corinthians say that verse 13 say, and now abide in faith, abide in hope, and abide in love. These three words are the greatest of this word is love. So I want to share with you about the love of God. And this particular text emphasizes main three important things. One, faith, then we look into love, and then we look into hope. And therefore, as we are on this mediation and this lay mediation, I just want to emphasize on these last three words that the Bible defines. Under faith, there are about six that we have to look into as a people of faith. But before we emerge into these six words in the light of faith, I would like to share with you first with the word faith to define it. According to African Bible study, faith is defined as reliance, loyalty, complete trust in God. In the light of these words, we are commanded by God to live a life of faith. This is according to 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 to 7. Live a life of faith. As Christians, regardless of the challenges that we are facing, we are expected to live a life of faith. Number two, we need to cling to your faith, you particularly as people of God, we ourselves. We have to cling to our faith in Christ, cling to faith, which means remain in faith. That is according to 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 18 to 19. Paul was advising Timothy to remain in faith. Also, we are also advised to avoid turning away from faith regardless of challenges that we are facing. This is also according to 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 to 12. Verse 1 up to 12. We are expected not to turn away from faith. Whether we are facing challenges, we are facing difficulties, we have to remain in faith. And also, as Christians, we have to remain in fighting a good fight of faith. Fight a good fight of faith. As Christians, we need to remain in the fighting company or remain in fighting our faith. It's not a fight to throw a stone, to blow a gun, but it is a fight to remain faithfully, regardless of challenges that you are facing. This is according to 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12 to 13. We have also to defend our faith. We must defend the faith by doing good, but by not doing bad. We must remain faithful to the Lord. This is according to Jude 1, verse 3. Place our faith in the hope of God. We must really put our faith in the hope of God. We need to know that our faith is not just in an isolation. You must place your faith and hope in God. This is according to 1 Peter, 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. That is the faith that God wants us. God wants us to remain in the life of faith. Number two, God wants you and I to cling to faith. Number three, God wants you and I not to turn away from faith if things are very difficult. Number four, God wants us to fight a good fight of faith. God wants us to defend faith. God wants us to remain in faith. Move to hope in the light of faith in the suffering of this world. God expects you and I to put our hope in the word of God. This is according to Psalm 119, verse 75. Put your hope in the word of God. When we put our hope in the word of God, although the trials may be hard, whether we are undergoing all these persecutions, we are undergoing all these trials of the coronavirus, and we put our hope in God, we will not be shaken. Number two, we have to put a hope of confidence of salvation in Christ. Our salvation, it is both now and in the future. And we must put our confidence of hope in salvation of Christ. This is according to Romans 5, verse 4. Number three, under hope in these circumstances, we have to know that God gave you and I hope of encouragement. Regardless of the problem that we are facing, we still have hope and encouragement. When you have hope, we have also encouragement. This is according to Romans 15, verses 3 to 4. God also wants you and I to know that God is the source of hope in the trial. This is according to Romans 15, verse 13. We have to know that our God is source of hope. And if God is source of our hope, nothing will shake us. Nothing will sway us away from the Lord. And if we know that God is source of hope, we have to know that our hope is in the living God. If our hope is in the living God, we will not shy away. We will remain, we will be glad even though the situation is worse and bad. This is according to 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 10. Move to love, which is the last word that I'm sharing with you, my brothers and sisters. We want to share with you in this area of love, in the situation life where, as we are facing, we have to know that God is love. If we know that God is love, and even though we are in trial, we know that we are in the time of Lent, we are praying to our God, fasting and praying, we know that God is love. Even though we are in trial, we know that God is love. And if God is love and love us, then there's nothing that will sway us away. This is according to 1 John chapter 3:16. Love covers multitudes of sins. Jesus Christ was sent by God himself to cover up, really not for us to see the sin in our brothers or somebody else that has repented to God. God does not see him as a sinner. Since God has brought his son Jesus Christ, he made us to be clean, he made us to be holy, and to stay in holiness because God has covered the sin. This is according to 1 Peter chapter 4, 18. Love expels all fear. When we are not, God has not given us a spirit of intimidation. We cannot be intimidated by any situation because God has given us all the zeal to serve him. This is according to John, 1 John chapter 4, 18, that love expels all fear. Number four, we have to know that if we will obey and remain in the love of God, he will be with us. So we have to know that in a situation like this, we know that once we remain in him, nothing will change us. Nothing will remove us away from God. Love does not count on wrong. It does not count wrong on the expense of those who have been redeemed. God cannot continue counting us as sinners after we have received Christ. This is according to Romans 13, verse 10. Let us love our neighbor. This is according to Matthew 19:19. We have to love our neighbor. Neighbor does not mean literally your neighbor. It may be your neighbor, and maybe also your neighbor who believes in Christ. So therefore now, God is extending to us, telling us that we have to love one another. And we have also to love one another as Christ loved us. These are the few words that I fail to share with you at this particular time of Lent, my brothers, to know that even though the situation is worse for us, even though we are undergoing trials, God has given us a hope. Above all, God also has given us a hope and love. All these three words will remain steadfast with you and will make us to be resilient. It will make us to stand still. With this regard, I charge you in the name of the Lord, and I pray the Lord will continue with you and continuously on this side. May God bless you.